Hello and a very warm welcome. In today's video, we're talking Nico Hülkenberg, tall, dark, handsome, and an unbelievable underrated driver. Nico Hülkenberg. I've even contemplated me missus. Like, I would genuinely tuck this guy into bed with my missus. She declined, but I mean, I'd sleep on the sofa for a night. The guy's a god, honestly. I'm a bit of a fanboy of Nico Hülkenberg. I mean, he's not my favourite driver, but he's definitely in my top five. Underrated, criminally underrated, delivers week in, week out. And I tell you what, you pull him in Sergio Perez's position, he's on the podium week in, week out. And probably pushing Max. He is a top driver, Nico Hülkenberg. 11th in the drivers with 22 points. Hülkenberg is the main reason Haas are only 4 points off Racing Bulls. Look at the start Racing Bulls had. Tsunoda reeling points off like a slot machine. And now, because of Nico Hülkenberg, Haas find themselves in the fight with Racing Bulls. Very impressive by Nico Hülkenberg. He's always been underrated, but he doesn't get the respect he deserves. He's a Le Mans winner. He's been on pole in a Williams. He's beat Carlos Sainz as teammates. And yet, I don't know. Because he drives a Haas, he's not in a big team. He doesn't get the respect he deserves. He's criminally underrated at this level. Just checking the constructors now. Yeah, Racing Bulls 31, Haas 27. They're in the fight for 6 in the constructors. And it's down to one man. And that is Mr. Saturday. 9-3 in qualifying to Kevin Magnussen. Always delivers on a Saturday. If you want a dark horse, wet, dry, any condition, look out for Hülkenberg. He'll be in Q3. He is an exceptional talent. Is he world class? No. Is he a great? No. But he's definitely a very good driver. Look at all the times everyone was dropping with COVID. Oh, they literally got on the phone. Hello, is that Nico? Yeah, what are you doing? Oh, I'm sat on my sofa. Do you want to come and drive an F1 car? And literally, he'd literally turn up to Silverstone and, you know, just delivers, doesn't he? Week in, week out. And that is what he's doing at the minute. He's hammering Kevin Magnussen. And basically, his performances have got him an Audi drive in the future. He goes to Sauber in 2025. At the minute, that looks an absolute awful move. Sauber yet to score. Hülkenberg's going to that team. But then they turn into Audi. Audi want a German driver. Hülkenberg is the only German on the grid. So, makes sense. He's always labelled, he's never been on the podium. And I would argue he's never had the machinery to be on the podium. A best finish of 4th. He did that at Korea and he did it at, Spa. He's had a good career, a very good career. And yeah, he's never had the machinery. Look at his teams. He started at Williams, he got a pole at Williams. Then he went to Force India. Then he went to Sauber, then back to Force India, had a go at Renault. Renault, he beat Carlos Sainz. Everyone raves about Carlos Sainz. Oh, he's underrated, you know. Hülkenberg's beat him in the season at Renault. And then he came Aston Martin. Obviously, in that time, he won Le Mans as well. I would say Nico Hülkenberg is the most underrated driver on the grid. And look at his last two performances. Look at them. He's in a Haas, for goodness sake. He finishes 6th at Austria and backs it up with a 6th at Silverstone. Tricky conditions, in a Haas, no problem. 6th place for Nico Hülkenberg. Outstanding. Outstanding by Nico Hülkenberg. He's an Audi-bound driver. He's performing at a high level. And I say, pull him in that Red Bull. He delivers week in, week out. Not a problem. Experience and a great racing, like knowledge. Brilliant. Not given enough credit as he is in the midfield team, but he's undervalued, underrated. and underappreciated, really, I would say. He's won Le Mans, but that podium is what haters will always throw at him. So close in 2012. Brazil 2012 is where it was at. He should have been on the podium that race. Ironically, that was Lewis Hamilton's last race for McLaren. And it was a bit wet, it won it, and Hülkenberg slid into Hamilton. Hamilton retired. Hülkenberg then ended up finishing outside of the podium. But yeah, honestly, I really do like Nico Hülkenberg. I wish he would get a top drive. Honestly, I wish Red Bull would just pull him in for the rest of the season and give him a top drive for half a season. Comment down below your thoughts on Nico Hülkenberg. Honestly, the discussions have been had in the house that I would tuck Nico Hülkenberg into bed with me missus. She's not that willing. I was like, come on, he's tall, dark, handsome, beautiful German. Tall, 7 foot. I've got some persuading to do. She daggers at me. Adios. Adios.